China is building the largest water diversion projects in the world, which is also one of the most ambitious and expensive engineering projects in human history. The projects aim to channel 44.8 billion cubic meters of fresh water each year from the south to the north of China through many large channels that connect to each other. This water is intended for the dry industrial populations in the north. Let's take a closer look at the water transfer projects from the south to north and see why they are building such an expensive and huge project and whether it will benefit all people or not. China is the world's second most populous country, with over 1.4 billion people. It is also one of the world's largest and most diverse countries, with a rich history and culture, a fast-growing economy, and a complex social and political system. A country that is often in the headlines but also full of surprises and mysteries. China is a huge country with a land area of about 9.6 million square kilometers, or about the same size as the United States. However, unlike the US, China's population is unevenly distributed across the country, with the most people living in the eastern and southern regions, and very few people living in the western and northern regions. One of the problems that caused this is that northern regions of China are facing water shortages compared to other regions because of several reasons, such as the natural distribution of the water resources in China is uneven, with 80% of the water concentrated in south, but the north having more populations, farmland and coal production. The climate change has reduced the rainfall and the glacial meltwater in the north, causing droughts and affecting the river flows and the groundwater recharge. The rapid urbanization and industrialization in the north have increased the water demand and consumption, as well as the water pollution and waste. To solve and prevent inequality, China planned the water transition project from the south to the north because of several water imbalance problems in the country. The north has only 20% of the country's water resources, but 40% of the population, 50% of the farmland, and 70% of the coal production. The water demand in the north exceeds supply by over 40 billion cubic meters per year, which leads to water scarcity, pollution, and ecological degradation. The project is supposed to alleviate this problem by providing more water for domestic, agriculture, and industrial use. The project was first proposed by Mao Zedong in 1952. Mao Zedong discussed the idea for a mass engineering project as an answer to China's water problems. He reportedly said, "There is plenty of water in the south, not much water in the north. If at all it's possible, borrowing some water would be good." But it was not officially approved until 2002. After 2002, they started to build. The water transfer project from the south to the north in China is multi-gauge infrastructure megaproject that aims to channel 44.8 billion cubic meters of fresh water each year from the Yangtze River in southern China to more arid and industrialized north through three canal systems: the eastern, the central, and the western. The project is expected to cost over $18 billion and take more than 50 years to complete. By 2014, more than $79 billion had been spent, making it one of the most ambitious and expensive engineering projects in human history. The eastern road consists of the upgrade to the Grand Canal, which is the world's longest and oldest artificial waterway. The water from the Yangtze River is pumped by stations along the canal and through a tunnel under the Yellow River and down the aqueduct to reservoir near Tianjin. The Eastern Road began operations in November 2013 and it transferred about 14.8 billion cubic meters of water per year to the north. The main purpose of Eastern Road is to provide water for the provinces of Shandong, Jiangxi and Hebei, as well as the municipalities of Tianjin and Beijing. The Eastern Road also helps to reduce the groundwater, overexploitations, and land subsidence in the north. The Eastern Road is about 1,150 kilometers long. However, the Eastern Road also faces some challenges and problems, such as the high cost and energy consumption of pumping water, the water pollution and waste along the canal, displacement and resettlement of millions of people, and the potential impact on the water security. Western Road. The Western Road is the most challenging and controversial one, as it involves diverting water from the three tributaries of Yangtze River near the Bayankla Mountains, the upper reach of the Yellow River through tunnels and canal. The Western Road is still under construction, and it is expected to transfer about 17 billion cubic meters of water per year to the north. The main purpose of the Western Road is to provide the water for the provinces of Jinhai, Gansu, Shaanxi, Shaanxi, Inner Mongolia, Ningxia, which cover from severe water shortage and desertification. Central Road. The Central Road runs from the Danjiangku Reservoir and Han River, a tributary of the Yangtze River, to Beijing and Hebei. This project involves raising the height of the Danjiangku Dam by increasing the dam's crest elevation from 162 meters to 176.6 meters above sea level. The Central Road began operations in December 2014 and it transferred about 13 billion cubic meters of water per year to the north. The main purpose of the Central Road is to provide the water for the capital city of the Beijing and the surrounding areas, which suffer from chronic water shortages and the groundwater depletion. The Central Road also helps to improve the water quality and ecology of the high river basin, which is one of the most polluted and degraded river systems in China. The Central Road is about 1,270 kilometers long. The general road created by the South-to-North Water Diversion Project is approximately 4,350 kilometers long, which is about the same distance as from New York to Los Angeles. Therefore, the project doesn't benefit all people equally, but rather creates winners and losers, depending on their location and values. Some people may gain more water, wealth and well-being, while others may lose their land, livelihood and identity. I hope you learned something new and interesting about the South-North Water Transfer Project. If you did, please let me know in the comments below. What do you think about this project? Do you think it is a good idea or bad idea? Do you know any other examples of water transfer projects in the world? I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified when we upload new videos. And follow along with one of the most biggest megaprojects that can be interesting for you.